Say hello.
Hello. We want to tell you about a cute little town that we visited recently.
It's called Greyton. It's about 1.5 hours drive right outside of Cape Town.
It is known to be one of those little villages that you just have to go to because it's just so quaint and cute.
Made a lot of effort to make that place look good.
And so we decided to spend Christmas there.
So let's take you on this 1.5 kilometer drive. 1.5 kilometer. So let's take you on this 140 kilometer drive.
We managed to book a gorgeous little Airbnb. Because there were four of us going, it was nice and spacious. We had the entire place to ourselves.
Double story house, so there's bedrooms downstairs, massive bedroom upstairs, lovely veranda.
Best is it really gives you the feeling of living there. Like you get to immerse yourself as one of the locals in the village because you're not staying in a hotel that's all catered for tourists. In fact, you are just one of the locals. Greytonians?
That sounds so good.
Yeah.
Well, you let us know what you call yourselves.
We had a fantastic Christmas with all the trimmings and festivities. Managed to get a game of bowls in there. Is it bowls? Boulé. Isn't there another word for it?
There's another word for it.
Patank?
I think that's it.
There was another word.
Well, you tell us how you pronounce it and what it is. I particularly loved the houses as we walked down the little street that we stayed in. This beautiful architecture. People really made a lot of effort with their houses.
Gorgeous gardens, trees and flowers everywhere. Not to mention the friendly animals that you come across while you walk down the street.
Pretty little cat.
An awesome happy horse. For the adventurous folk who don't want to necessarily lie around the pool for your entire stay, there is a lovely nature reserve with what we hear is some fantastic waterfalls.
Yeah, we didn't get to the waterfall. You have to drop all your gear and you have to get wet to get to the waterfall, and we brought a lot of gear with us, so.
For next time, note to self, leave the cameras at home and bring your cozy with.
Even though we prepared our own food, there's also lovely restaurants there. I think there's some fantastic food to be had there. Except the one place we went to that didn't cater for vegans at all, and even to have coffee, we had to buy our own soy milk. And they were quite happy to make the cappuccinos with the soy milk that we had bought next door.
I think you're really spoiled for choice when it comes to restaurants and places to eat in Greyton. Considering its size, how small it is, there's so many eating establishments there. If you are a vegan like us, you will have to just look around and ask for special requests.
So if you want more information about the B&B we stayed in, the Airbnb we stayed in, we'll put the links to that establishment down below if you're looking for a house to stay in Greyton. Great place to go. So we hope you enjoyed that little trip through Greyton.
We hope you go and visit and experience it for yourself. We certainly enjoyed it and we'll definitely be back. If there's anything that you would suggest we do next time we go to Greyton that we perhaps missed this time, let us know in the comments down below.
We'd love to hear from you.
And as for where we are right now,
that's a little mystery.
You'll have to wait till the next video.